Welcome to Maxability. To unfold different layers of knowledge, stay tuned with us till the end of the video.
Hello everyone, welcome to Maxability. This is lesson 8 of the series Using Mac with VoiceOver. In this lesson, we're going to talk about some shortcut commands and using rotor on Safari with VoiceOver. If you want to see the basic navigation methods, watch our previous lesson, lesson 7. So let us get started. Similar to what you have been probably using in Windows, using NVDA and JAWS to jump from one similar type of control to a other similar type of control, you use quick navigation keys. Similarly, on Mac with VoiceOver, on Safari or any other browser, also have the same kind of functionality. You can jump from one heading to another. You can go from one image to other or one form control to another. You can either use the shortcut commands of VoiceOver or alternatively, you can also use the VoiceOver's rotor feature. So let us see how to do that. As usual, to check whether I'm right on the right page or not, I have to use VO Shift I.
Home, Maxability, page has 45 links, 16 headings, 6 form controls, 4 landmarks, 1 image.
Perfect. I'm on the page I'm looking for. Now, the usual navigational methods or the popular navigation method of a screen reader user is to find the first heading or the main heading of the page whenever they come onto the page to directly jump on to the main content region. The shortcut command to go to the first heading on the page is VO command H, control option command H.
Heading level 1, Maxability.
It directly jumped on to heading level 1, Maxability. To the next heading, do the same thing again.
Heading level 2, web accessible difficulties. Heading level 2, about Maxability.
About Maxability. And if I have to go to the previous heading, I have to press control option command shift H.
Heading level 2, web accessible difficulties.
I have gone to the previous heading.
Heading level 1, Maxability. First heading, heading level 1, Maxability.
So it says that's the first heading, so I can't go further. Control option command shift H to the previous heading. Similarly, if you have to go to the next image, do the same thing. Control option command G.
Image not found.
Image not found. There are no images on the page. Let me see.
Maxability had been invigorating.
So let me go and check if there are any images before this control, before this content. Control option command shift G.
Maxability logo visited link image.
So it says Maxability logo
visited towards an inclusive web
image. So there is an image. Similarly, if I have to find whether there are any tables on the page, control option command T.
Table not found.
There are no tables on the page. If I go previous, control option command shift T.
Table not found.
No tables found. For forms, control option command J.
Search. Search text field. Blank.
Search.
Submit. Button.
Submit button.
Full name star. Required. Edit text with autofill menu.
So if you know there is a form and you are supposed to fill to open the auto on the page, just once you load the page, press control option command J, you will be placed on the first form control on the page. So that's with the shortcut commands. So I'll be pasting a link for all the shortcut commands of VoiceOver in the description. You can check that for more commands. The next one is to use the rotor feature. What you can do is press VO command, left and right arrows. I'm pressing right arrow.
Images.
So when you hear images, you can press up and down arrows. VO command plus up arrow or right arrow. Oh, sorry, up arrow plus down arrow to go to the images. Let me look at the headings. I am pressing control option command right arrow.
Navigation.
Until I hear headings.
Characters. Words. Window spots. Misspelled. Links. Headings.
When I hear headings, I can use control option command up arrow for previous heading and down arrow for next heading.
Heading level 2. Subscribe to us. Heading level 2. Categories.
I'm going up because there are no headings after this one.
Heading level 2. Subscribe to us.
This is the last heading on the page. Pressing down arrow, control option command down arrow, nothing happens. So that's how we use the rotor to navigate quickly from one similar item to a different similar item. So we will be discussing probably in detail on using rotor in a separate lesson, probably in the advanced stage. But for now, this is the way how to use the quick commands on VoiceOver with Safari using Mac. Thank you for watching this video.
Thank you for watching and being with us. Please like and share the video. Don't forget to click on the bell icon. And also, for more updates, subscribe the channel.